And now, a side-by-side product comparison.
It's time for a side-by-side product comparison between these two turntables. On this side, we have an Audio-Technica AT-LP120-USB direct drive professional turntable. This is a $300 turntable. This one is an older version that comes with the Audio-Technica AT-P2 DJ cartridge, while the ones you can buy today come with the AT-95E audiophile cartridge. It's debatable how much of a difference that makes. The AT-95E generally gets better reviews, but actually I've heard from some people who prefer the AT-P2 DJ cartridge. It has a recommended tracking force range of 3 to 5 grams. I have it set to the low end of the scale at 3 grams. And as you may have seen in my video about it, I performed a preampectomy on this turntable, so I removed the internal preamp and USB board, so now it has a direct output from the phono cartridge, and I also added a ground wire. And here's what I'm using as my preamp. It's a DAC mixer with a phono preamp built in, and this also lets me adjust my level here, so I can try to make it at the same audio level as the output from this turntable. I'm actually feeding the output of the mixer into the line input of this unit here, just to make it equal so they'll both be going through the same amplifier. This is a Quasar CS-7030 stereo system from the 1980s, made by Panasonic. Quasar was sort of a mid-range brand between Panasonic and Technics. For example, this uses the same cassette mechanism as a lot of Technics cassette decks. Otherwise, it's fairly basic. You just get volume, tone, and balance. I have them all set to the mid-range position. I'm going to be using the headphone output because this does not have a line output, and that will be fed into the input of this camcorder here, and I'll also be connecting the S-video output of this camcorder into that one to provide a video signal, and that will be going into my laptop, which is capturing the video right now. As for this turntable, it uses a ceramic cartridge, and you don't even want to know how heavy the tracking force is. So it's a ceramic cartridge, and this is a belt drive turntable. It actually uses a belt jump system to switch between 33 and 45, which is a little bit unusual. Whereas, of course, this one is direct drive. And there's a trimmer underneath. I adjusted the speed to be as close as possible to the correct speed. So I'll play two selections, both from the Arthur Murray Orchestra, from two different LPs. One is from an Admiral 1960s stereo demonstration record, and one is from a Reader's Digest Arthur Murray dance album. So I'll be switching back and forth between these two turntables at regular intervals. And like I said, they'll be both fed through this amplifier. I'll just be switching between the two different inputs here, so that way you can hear the difference between these two turntables and decide for yourself whether a $300 professional direct drive turntable sounds better than a junky old stereo from the 1980s.
Listen carefully.
Lancaster Cathedral. You're bringing me down. You stood and you watched as my baby left town. You could have done something, but you didn't try. You didn't do nothing. You let her walk by. Now everyone knows just how much I needed that girl. She wouldn't have gone far away if only you started ringing your bell. Winchester Cathedral, you're bringing me down. You stood and you watched as my baby left town. Everyone knows just how much I needed that girl. She wouldn't have gone far away if only you started ringing your bell. Winchester Cathedral, you're bringing me down. You stood and you watched as my baby left.
Do you like this demonstration? Enjoy it, because our competition never gave you the opportunity. Thank you for your patience while listening to this demonstration.